And you watch film all through the night only to wake up. You are not disturbing them with, please give me 1,000. Please give me this. Please give me. I want to start a business. So, if 10 people can give me 2,000. Where is that 10 people? Where you are watching is film. You are watching. Hallelujah to Jesus. You look at students' phone. Students' phone, even during holiday, is film. Full of films. Ah, students. When your mates are learning how to make cream, your mates are learning how to make soap, your mates are learning how to sew clothes, your mates are learning how to do some things in the garden, your mates are learning how to sell things online, your mates are learning how to make bags and shoes, your mates are learning how to do makeup, how to do style, you know, hair and things like that. All you do is films. The new film has come out now. I can't remember the last time I watched film. Hallelujah to Jesus. And you will now be disturbing one uncle. One uncle. That is not sleeping, that is working. To now begin to give his salary and give you to buy data so that you can download more film and become more useless. And that's why we copy the lifestyle you can't sustain. You see a secondary school boy, the way he wants to dress, he wants to, because that's what he sees in the film. He wants to dress like one of these stars, the actors. That's what he's seeing. But the dignity of the work is not there. The dignity of the work is not there. Nobody thinks, what will I be doing the next 5 years? Nobody thinks, what will I be doing the next 15 years? And that's why innovation in Africa is very poor. Very poor. Innovation very poor here. Why? The white people, they bring gadgets down. 80% of people that use Facebook, they are from Africa and Asia. Down here. And they call us third world, developing countries. Whatever technology they have there, they ship it down here. Do you know that even Bill Gates that had Microsoft, he hardly used computer. Steve Jobs that made Apple did not have one Apple phone. He used Motorola. Bill Gates does not have TV. Doesn't have a cable in his house. Those are men that need the word. If you want to make news, hallelujah to Jesus, you won't be part of the, you know, of the people. You will stay somewhere and make news. You think you can compose a very good song by walking around the streets? Go and ask those people that make quality songs. Even Two-Face tells you, 3 months, in those days when he was making good songs, he will stay inside the bush and sit down and listen to himself and listen to his spirit before he can bring out a song. You think song just fly? Except he will sing Nigeria Daga Daga. Hallelujah to Jesus. And instead of people to be blessed by your song, they are cursing you. You know, there's some song you hear, people will be cursing the mother of the person that sang the song. You will be frustrated. There's one useless woman. You think she's singing gospel? She's singing bastard song. How many of you have? One day I was buying fuel in the, and I listened to her. I thought she was singing gospel and I was hearing nonsense. I said, ah. Can you imagine? And I said, which song is this you are playing here? They said, woman buruku kaba in the yellow call. I said, you know, sing koni buruku lepo, buruku lepo, buruku lepo. Praise the Lord. I mean, that's what you see. The feedback you have. Number four. A man that shows mercy. Matthew 25, verse 37 and 40. A man that shows mercy. The man that God will reward. God will reward you with mercy if you show mercy. Matthew 25, verse 37 to 40. Luke chapter 14, verse 12 to 14.
Matthew 25, verse 7.
Yes.
Then shall the righteous answer him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee, and hungered, and fed thee, or thirsty, and gave thee drink? When saw we a stranger and took thee in, or naked and clothed thee? Or when saw we thee sick or in prison and came unto thee? And the king shall answer and said unto them, Verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of this my brethren, ye have done it unto me.
A man that show mercy. Jesus Christ said, inasmuch as you have done it to someone else, you have done it to me. I was talking to a friend today. How many people give gifts to people that cannot pay them back? Hallelujah to Jesus. How many people give gifts to people that cannot pay them back? If they are not in the position to pay them back. Something happened some years ago, and it's a big lesson to me. Sheyi Makinde wanted to come and do campaign in Lautech. In those days, it was against, is it Adelabo or Adedibo or what now? Penkelemes. He wanted to, and Penkelemes is a candidate of APC. Sheyi Makinde, and then APC was the governor in town that was about to go, Ajimobi. And Sheyi Makinde wanted to come and campaign in Lautech, and they stopped him from coming to Lautech. How many of you heard about the case? They never allowed him to come into the Lautech, into Lautech and campaign. And one of their boys, the president in those days, said, no, he should come. He should come. And that boy shall organize something around, and I think he campaigned and left. But they never wanted to allow him. The same Sheyi Makinde is here today, that is a blessing to Lautech. And that boy that was the president is now one of his special advisors or something now. That gave him a letter. Come and walk. If Sheyi Makinde says he needs 10 billion naira today, that people should contribute, do you know they will give him? Why? They know they will get contract back. That was why Davido could get that money. You ask for that money and see if they will give you. Even fake that you are sick and see. That's when you will know that people don't love you. As some of you that carry your hair and you think people love you, pretend that you are sick and send that people to send money. You'll be disappointed. What? Even if they send, it can't buy paracetamol. Hallelujah to Jesus. Why? They will give to people that they know they can collect back. It's a normal thing. And if you give like that, you are lopsided. You are doing it in the way of the world. And the same Davido, wise boy, carried all the money and gave it to the poor. Hallelujah to Jesus. But it took him to ask for it. Took him to ask for it. How many pastors will ask for money and people will give like that? Hallelujah to Jesus. Some of you think pastors don't work. Go and look at pastors' schedule and how far they give. How far pastors give. If they don't give you, don't be annoyed. You never can tell. Before you ask them, 10 people have asked. So will he kill himself? Hallelujah to Jesus. And they give, they are not giving to people that can pay them back. They give to people that cannot. So if you show mercy, the Lord will bring mercy back to you. Those people said, when did we do those things? Said, as much as you have done it for someone else. As long as you have done it for someone else. Some people come to church, they don't even have money to eat. And yet you have plenty of food in your house. And there's nothing you do about it. Hallelujah to Jesus. There's nothing you do about it. And you know this person is like, he has problem. Jesus Christ said, as long as you do it for others, in a day, can somebody laugh because of you? That I laugh today, just 2 sticks of Indomie, I laugh. Oh, I laugh today just because of this person, because of what this person did. I want us to rise upon our feet this evening. We continue next week. A man that God rewards. The kind of man that God rewards. Are you a workman? How do you treat work? Do you see work as a burden? Someone says, opportunity puts an overall on and it looks like work. 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 What is your reaction to work? Send some people something. They will give enough excuse why they can't do it. Why they cannot do it. Lift your hands to heaven. Esther chapter 6 verse 6, that's the scripture we are using. He said, and the king remembered Mordecai. Anointing for divine remembrance. Your parents have done something good for some people. Your grandparents are not that wicked. They have done something good for people. But tonight, God will remember the good things they have done, the good things you have done. And God will bring the reward onto your doorstep. in the name of Jesus Christ. Reward. I know a sister. When she was about to marry, there was no money anywhere. But somebody who had been a friend to her mother remembered them from the US. And she began to pump the money. It's called reward. It's called prayer. Reward. Reward of prayer. Tonight, people will remember you in the name of Jesus Christ. Listen, there are people that they carry your blessing. They have the heart, but the means is not there. Oh, I wish I have this money. I would have blessed this man. I wish I have this money. I would have supported this ministry. I wish I have this money. I would have raised him up. I wish I have this means. I would have assisted this family. Tonight, God will remember those people because of you. In the name of Jesus Christ. They will have that thing, and you will have that thing as well. In the name of Jesus Christ. Until they are remembered, you may not be remembered. Call on Rati and Olori. Hallelujah. Somebody can be your brother, your sister. If your blessing is not in their hand, it can be rich. It will remember you. Amen. We will do it to your friend and forget you. But for the right people that carry your blessing, this anointing that will come upon your head will form a flame and wake them up in the name of Jesus Christ. Many will not be able to sleep because they need to bless you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Some will call you very early. Send your account number over. I say send it now. My heart is burning. I must give you this money. So shall it be. In the name of Jesus Christ. People will help you. They will request for your name. They will ask for your name. Your name, your full name. The name you want it, the way you want it to appear on a check. So shall it be for you. In the name of Jesus Christ.